Welcome back to the channel, folks. I'm Barry Mountford, and in this video, I'm going to show you guys what I strongly believe is the king of lights for toy photography, a genre of photography which has exploded over the last few years, creating some amazing artists. And with the introduction of the CITI100Pro from Pixapro, this has allowed me to take my creativity level that step further. So that's what we're going to look at in this video. We're going to take a look at the specs of this light. I'm also going to show you guys some examples. So hopefully it'll give you some ideas to take away and use in your toy photography. Toy photography has exploded over the last few years. It's become super popular and created some amazing artists. There's some fantastic artists out there creating some amazing imagery. Now, what's really popular in toy photography is using LED lights, small little LED lights, which are great, and people are producing some amazing images. But one of the downsides to LED lighting is the power. There's just not loads of power coming out of them. So if you want to take your figures outside and create a scene outside somewhere, take them with you on a walk, find a really cool location, unless you're shooting in shade, LED lighting isn't really going to cut it for you. And that's where the CITI100Pro comes in really handy, because this is not only has the LED light built in, you've also got the use of about 2 speed lights worth of power in this unit, which is going to allow you to get really creative outside in bright daylight with your toys. You can set up the scene and start shooting and get really creative. We'll take a look at a couple of examples before I go through the specs of this light that I've shot at home in the garden. And that's a great thing about toy photography, is that you can do it anywhere. There's no restrictions in the home, in the bedroom, outside, on location. Anywhere you want to shoot toy photography, you can pick up a camera and start shooting straight away and get as creative as you possibly can. So let's take a look at this sample in the garden, and I'll explain why the LED lighting would fail in this situation and where you would kind of gain from having the power of the strobe. So you can see in this setup, it's a super simple setup. We've got a couple of characters which I'm setting up, and the idea was to create a little bit of a chase, but I wanted some kind of light rays coming down behind them, so I decided to use a colander from the kitchen. These have little holes in, so the idea is to cover the whole scene and get the camera just underneath. So obviously I can kind of surround the whole scene with this colander and the lights above. And I wanted to fill this colander with a bit of haze, so when I light it, all those light rays are going to come down. Now, LED lighting just wouldn't be powerful enough to do that. It wouldn't light up the whole scene. You could bump your ISO, but then you obviously incorporating a lot of grain in the image. So having the power of a strobe just backlighting that allowed me to create this image, which you see on the screen now, allows me to get that haze in, the mist, and all of those light rays coming down from the colander. It really is a handy tool to have that kind of power when you need it out creating. So if we take a look at this scene as well, I've shot this figure alone on top of a unit, and all I've done is backlit it and added some haze behind to create a really cool effect. Now, because we're shooting in bright sunlight, I've had to use the strobe and I've darkened down the scene. I'll pop the camera settings up on the screen so you can see what I mean. So having the power of the strobe allows me to do that, allows me to control the ambient light and get the power I need out of a little flash unit for toy photography. And you can see it's really effective, simply backlighting that and the little bit of fill lights coming from the bounce off the front of the element on the lens. Super effective way to create a really cool image. So again, being able to take your figures out on location anywhere in your garden in bright sunlight, but having the power of a flash to really light up your figure and create something really moody. Again, in this scene, you can see I've sent the dinosaur up in amongst the flower beds, and I'm just backlighting it again and using the haze machine to create a little bit of fog, a little bit of haze, a little bit of atmosphere in the image. And I'm using the power of the strobe to backlight it, which is illuminating everything I need in the image, creating a really cool effect. Again, this situation, LED lighting wouldn't be enough. I wouldn't be able to get that backlight coming on the figure. So that's where the power of a strobe comes in really handy. So you'd be asking, well, I want to use LED lighting. Well, we can, because obviously the Pixapro 100 Pro has the LED light on. It's a modern lamp, which you can adjust from power settings 1 to 10. So we'll take a look at this scene. I'm in the kitchen. Super simple scene, setting up on the kitchen bench. One figure, again, backlighting it using the haze. And you can see, using the modern lamp, how effective that really is. Now, the reason I've used the modern lamp in this situation is because this little demistifier obviously basically just pumps out fine sprays of water, which creates that mist. If I use flash, I'll show you this example, that's going to freeze all of the mist in the air, and that's not what I wanted. I wanted a slower shutter speed on my camera settings to allow me to create that really hazy effect in the smoke, to create like a really smoky effect in the image and allow me to get those lovely light rays coming through, as you see the figure casting from being backlit by the Pixapro 100 Pro. Super effective way of shooting toy photography, and having both the LED light and the strobe light in one unit has just changed the way I can shoot now. And super little light to go in my backpack, nice and portable. So let's look at the specs of the light. It's a 100 watt second light. You can control this from a trigger on your camera, so it means you can get that light anywhere you want, position anywhere. Obviously, you've got the modern lamp, which can be adjusted between power levels 1 and 10, which is super handy if you like seeing what you get. You can use both of them in conjunction with each other, so you can have the modern light on, and you can also use the power of the strobe, so you can know where that light's going to be falling on your subject before you get the power of the flash coming out. Now, this will work with any other of these lights in the range. So if you start with this light and then want to add them further down the line, this will work with the family of lights from Pixapro. Small, lightweight, it's about 580 grams, I do believe, so it's nice and light. It has a rechargeable battery, which charges, obviously, it's a lithium battery, and this will give you roughly about 360 full power flashes from this unit. Now, bear in mind, you very rarely shoot at full power because there's a lot of power in this unit for these little figures, so you're very rarely going to be shooting at full power. You can modify this light with some great attachments. It's got a magnetic front, so you can attach the magnetic attachments, which you can buy separately, and modify the light. So you've got a little snoot bond doors, colored gel, so you can get really super creative. So that's just the attachments for the light itself. If you want to go even more creative, you can actually attach this to a bracket and then start using bigger modifiers, different modifiers, to create a completely different effect and different look to your toy photography. So the possibilities with this over a standard LED light for your photography in toy photography is huge. And that's why I approached Pixapro and asked them if I could create a video about toy photography. Because as soon as I saw this, this is the first thing that came to my mind, was this genre of photography and where this would sit really well in that type of photography. And it's something I want to share with you folks. I think you will get a lot out of this unit if you take up shooting toys in your photography. It's a great genre of photography, one you'll have super fun doing, and you can create some amazing images and have so much fun. So that is my look at the CITI100 Pro from Pixapro. If you are interested in this unit, links will be in the description below. A fantastic bit of kit, and I'm super happy to be able to share that with you. Like I said, as soon as I saw this light, the genre of toy photography came straight in my mind. This is fantastic for that area of photography, and one that you will be able to get super creative in using this light. So there you go, folks. Thanks very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I will see you folks in the next one. See you then.